Today in our state, we have fewer. Offer to the children who are still waiting, and we must carry the burden to get them home forever. You can see their faces hanging on the outside of our building for November and through the end of the year, and you can also learn more by visiting the Arkansas Heart Gallery. We are committed, and we will not stop until each of them is home, and Arkansas has no more kids waiting. In other words, we're chasing zero. Thank you again for being here today and for joining us on this mission. We cannot do it alone. And now I would like to invite Governor Sarah Sanders to share a few words. Thank you.
Good morning. It is great to be here and join all of you in helping kick off National Adoption Month. And thank you, Tiffany, for sharing that amazing news, but more importantly, for the incredible work that you're doing and what you have done to help us get here. For the first time since Arkansas started keeping track, the number of kids waiting for adoption in our state has dropped below 200. This is because of the incredible and amazing men and women who are here in this room today. Some of you are state employees, including our amazing DCFS caseworkers. Others come from the nonprofit world like Project Zero and Every Child Arkansas. As governor, we gathered together the foster care and adoption advocates and signed an executive order to reform our system. You returned this report later this year and are working hard to make the recommendations a reality. We've expanded state support for foster and adoption families, and we're investing in our DCFS workforce and redesigning training models for prospective foster families. The reason we are here and able to celebrate this great milestone is because all of you are united in your goal to make sure every kid in our state is in a safe, supportive, and loving home. The progress you've managed to accomplish over the past few years has been truly remarkable. The statistics Tiffany cited are great, and they certainly deserve to be celebrated. But behind every number is a story, a kid who has probably been through more in his or her short life than any of us will ever have to deal with. To honor the strength
and generosity of their adoptive parents, I want to share a few stories of resiliency from our state. For those of you who have been involved in the adoption space, you know that oftentimes the hardest kids to find a forever home are for those who have almost aged out of the adoption process, the 13, 14, 15, and 16-year-olds. But just because these kids are older doesn't mean that they don't want a family, and it doesn't mean that they don't need love and support from a stable household. A story I heard recently came from a basketball coach and his wife here in Central Arkansas. The coach was holding tryouts for his team and had to go through the tough process of making cuts. After the final roster had been announced, the coach emailed one of the kids who had not made the team. His name was Trey. He said that he really admired his drive and would love to make him the manager that year. Trey accepted, and the 15-year-old came to every practice and became just as much a part of the team as any of the players. The coach also learned that Trey was bouncing around between several different foster homes at the time. As the two grew closer, the coach went home to his wife and asked her a question. How do you feel about adding someone to our family? Thankfully, she said yes. And he went to Trey, how would you feel about being adopted, even though you're just a few years away from aging out of the foster care system? Trey said that he would love to find his forever home. That was a few years ago, and that same year that they adopted Trey, the coach and his wife welcomed a baby to their family as well. Trey is now looking ahead to college and adult life. But he says that it's like he has been part of the family forever. And for the first time in his life, Trey's life is stable. I heard another adoption story recently that really emphasizes the endless generosity of Arkansas's adoption parents. Ziana is an 18-year-old developmentally disabled nonverbal young woman. Because of her age and unique needs, Ziana was described by some as unadoptable, but not by the amazing teams at Project Zero and DCFS. They have found her a loving, supportive home. And now she has an amazing bond with her mother. In fact, one of only two words that she has ever said is the word mom. These are the amazing stories that come from Arkansas's foster and adoption systems. And this National Adoption Month, I want to give our deepest thanks to the parents who welcome these kids into their homes and show our deepest admiration for the kids who have been through so much but still find a way to put a smile on each of our faces. Our adoption families are some of the best among us. This month and every month, let us thank them, support them, and if you're a parent with the ability to do so, we encourage you to join them. It's now my honor to introduce one of the women who has been a driving force behind the success of Arkansas's foster and adoption system, Christy Irwin. Christy is the executive director of Project Zero, and along with her husband, fostered more than 50 children over the course of the last 20 years. She was awarded the Congressional Angel in Adoption Award in 2009 and represented Arkansas as the American Mother of the Year in 2016. Christy, please come up and say a few words.
Oh my goodness, how do I follow that? Thank you so much, Governor Sanders, and thank you, Director Wright, Secretary Putnam, and Assistant Director Megan Dade. Thank you to everyone in this room and around the state who worked tirelessly on behalf of vulnerable kids and families. What an honor it is for me today to help kick off National Adoption Month and to shine a big, bright light on the children and teens in our state who are waiting to be adopted. Over the past 13 years, Ziana, I love you so much. You are just a bright, shining light. Oh, my goodness. Over the past 13 years, Project Zero has had the incredible opportunity to represent waiting kids and to fight alongside DCFS to find the right adoptive families for them. Together, we have raised awareness, built hope during the wait, hosted connection events and birthday parties, given lots of hugs and high fives and words of affirmation, and we've grown to deeply love the kids that we represent. We've shared their hopes and dreams for the future, and we've been heartbroken by the weight that they have to carry from the past. We've had the privilege of giving them a voice through working with filmmaker Nathan Willis to create short films featuring them. Over 800 short films to date. I've often said that if every Arkansan, every American, could sit in on just one interview, the number of waiting kids in our nation would be zero. You cannot unhear quotes like this from some of the bravest kids I know. I don't want to be the black sheep anymore. I remember what my mom looks like. Her hair smells like strawberries. Adoption is scary, but it sounds amazing. I've been hurt enough. I just want someone to love me. Adoption is a new life, a better life, with no DHS and with a family. A lot of my life I've felt invisible. I've never felt heard. Waiting kids belong to all of us. They matter. They are precious and unique. And they deserve a second chance to have the beautiful lives God intended for them to have. This Saturday, November 1st, Project Zero and DCFS will kick off National Adoption Month with an inaugural event called Chasing Zero, a 5K and a 1 mile fun run. The registration begins at 6:30 and the run begins at 8 a.m. at North Shore Riverwalk, beginning under the awning of Crystal Hill Elementary. We would absolutely love for you to join us as we raise awareness and funds for the urgent and important work we are honored to do. Because any day that goes by with a child waiting in foster care to be adopted is a day too long. We believe that with everything that is in us. And 24/7, we are fighting to make sure our kids are heard. What a gift it would be to cast a wider net so that every Arkansan would know about our waiting kids and would join us in the fight as we chase zero together until every single one of our waiting kids is home. Thank you so much for the honor of being here today. And I'd like to introduce my friend and a passionate advocate for the children and families that she represents, the Secretary of DHS, Chrissy Putnam.
I knew I was going to do that. We even practiced it. Good morning, everybody. Thank you again for being here. It's such an honor to have every single one of you here. We're very, very excited to kick off National Adoption Month. Unadoptable is unacceptable in the state of Arkansas and should be in our country as well. It's a very special time to highlight the important work surrounding adoption that the teams here at DCFS and DHS focus on year-round. And I just want to say a big, huge thank you to every single person here in the room and across the state with DCFS and DHS who take part in these kinds of events all the time. The work would be so much harder without our incredible partners like Every Child Arkansas and Project Zero. Every child deserves a family. It's humbling to see the efforts that go into making that a reality for our children in care who are available for adoption. I am so, so proud of the teams who have worked incredibly hard to bring the number of waiting kids in our state under 200. It was more than 300 when I first arrived at DHS in January of 2023. That is huge. We're going to build on that momentum during National Adoption Month. Director Wright mentioned the banners outside, hanging outside, featuring our waiting kids, and I'm excited to add that periodically during the course of the month, we are going to, and through the end of the year actually, we are going to be placing these stickers, these adopted stickers, on the banners as we have kids who find their forever families. I can't wait to see how many of these stickers we have by the end of the year. Before we, and we're not going to go out to see the banners today unless you want to brave some raindrops, which is perfectly fine, but rain or shine, the work of our teams across the state continues and the work of our partners continues each and every day. I want to say a special thanks to all of our staff again, to Governor Sanders and First Gentleman for being here, to Christy Irwin and Project Zero, to all of our partners, to all of our adoptive families, to our legislators who are here and present and who always emphasize the importance of the work that we do. We are very grateful. If you're interested in learning more about the kids on the banners, you can visit the Arkansas Heart Gallery and Project Zero's website. And again, just thank you for being here. We will display those banners proudly through the end of the year. Please stop by and check them out when you can. Take a selfie, send it to DHS. We'll gladly post it. And I'd like to invite our adoptive families who are here today to join us up here at the front for a couple of quick pictures. And again, just want to say thank you, and we can't wait to see these stickers going up. Thank you, everyone.